You are watching this video because you use Outlook to store your calendar, contacts, and tasks, and you want to synchronize them with your Windows Phone. The best way to synchronize your data between Outlook and your Windows Phone is using Akruto Sync. What's special about Akruto Sync is that it does not use an online account to synchronize your data. The data is synchronized directly between your computer and your phone. Because there is no online account involved, Akruto Sync does not suffer from the limitations imposed by online services. Akruto Sync can handle a very large number of items. On this computer, I have over 12,000 Outlook contacts, as you can see in the Outlook status bar. Akruto Sync does not limit how much data you synchronize. 12,000 or even 50,000 items are synchronized without a problem. Let's look at one of the contact cards in Outlook. I have added a photo to this contact card. Unlike some cloud-based options, Akruto Sync lets you synchronize contact photos. If you like adding a lot of notes to your contacts or appointments, you will be pleased that Akruto Sync does not impose a limit on how long your notes are. As an example, I added a very long note to this contact card. These are complete sonnets by William Shakespeare. The total length of this note is over 96,000 characters. Akruto Sync can sync it in its entirety. You can add multiple phone numbers, email addresses, mailing address, and so on. Akruto Sync will sync anything that both Outlook and the phone can display. As far as your calendar, Akruto Sync will sync all your past and future appointments. This is unlike cloud services, which limit you to 2 weeks or a month of past appointments. With Akruto Sync, if you want to keep several years' worth of history on your calendar, you can synchronize it. Your synchronization software is not going to impose a limit. Calendar reminders will sync without a problem, as will all day appointments and recurring appointments. Same great support for tasks, including task reminders, task completion, either on the phone or in Outlook, and recurring tasks. Some people have trouble finding the task app on their Windows phone. To see tasks, you need to open the calendar app and swipe your finger to the left or to the right until you see the tasks, or as the Windows phone calls them, to-dos. Another great thing about Akruto Sync is that you do not need to move your data to an online account. Akruto Sync works with your existing Outlook data, and you can continue to use the account or accounts that you have. Now I am going to demonstrate how to configure and use Akruto Sync. I have just installed Akruto Sync on this computer. This put a shortcut to Akruto Sync program on my desktop. I'm going to start Akruto Sync by double-clicking the shortcut. When you run Akruto Sync for the first time, it asks you to configure it to sync with your phone. You do this by clicking the Configure Akruto Sync link. So I'm going to click the link now. This screen is asking me whether I want to sync over the internet or my home wireless network. I am going to choose my home network because it is a bit easier to configure. Now I am asked to make sure that Wi-Fi is turned on my phone. So I am going to take my phone and make sure that Wi-Fi is on. Scroll the application list. Find settings. And Wi-Fi is on. Back to Akruto Sync. I am going to click Continue. The next screen is asking me to take my phone and browse to an address. There are screenshots to show me what to do on my phone, and the address is shown right here, So I am going to take my phone again and start the Internet Explorer. Okay, here is the Internet Explorer icon. I'm going to tap the icon. The address needs to be entered in the address bar at the bottom of the screen. This is a Windows 8 phone. If you have an older Windows 7 phone, the address bar is at the top. But on the Windows 8 phone, it is at the bottom, right here. So I tap the address bar and the virtual keyboard pops up. You can see that as I type, the phone is suggesting some websites to me. It is very important to ignore the suggestions and enter the address exactly as it appears on the Akruto Sync screen. Now that I have entered the address, I am going to tap the Enter key right here. This tells the phone to open the website. The page loads. There is some explanatory text and a link to import my computer's SSL certificate. The certificate is used to secure communications between my phone and Akruto Sync. I am going to tap the link. The phone shows a confirmation screen and I tap Install. The phone tells me that certificate was installed successfully. The screen actually flips back to install certificate screen. But we don't need to worry about this. I am looking at the Akruto Sync screen on my computer. The screen has changed because Akruto Sync recognized that I imported the certificate. I click the Continue button. I now choose a username and a password. You can make up your own username and password. The only important thing is to remember the username and password that you choose, so that you can enter them into your phone. I choose Sync as my username and a super secret password. Type the password again. Click Continue. Now, the final screen asks me to create an Outlook account on the phone. Some screenshots here to show me how to do this. I take my phone again. Go to Settings, Email and Accounts, Add an account. The phone offers me a choice of several account types. It is important to select the Outlook account type. So I select Outlook. Now I need to enter an email address and a password. The email is what appears on Akruto Sync screen. I type it here. The password has to be the same that I previously entered into Akruto Sync. I click Sign In. And we are done! Akruto Sync screen shows that sync is in progress. We let the sync complete and we are done. Thanks for watching! This is the first video in a series with many more videos to come. Subscribe to our channel so that you can easily find our other videos.